All right, let's talk about volcanoes. This is Hawaii, and here's our, I believe, a hibiscus. It's a beautiful looking flower on the Hawaiian island of Kauai. Let me see if this remote's gonna work. And this is the Nepali coast. You can see the volcanics here. It's also very wet in the tropical climate. There is a trail that goes along here. And of course, you could take a boat. They also grow lots of taro for poi, which is a Polynesian food that they eat. So that's what you're seeing right here. Assume that's taro. And you can see it is very tropical. I'm afraid to pronounce this Mount Waliali, I keep going on and on. But Mount Waliali is one of the wettest places on the planet. That's right up above there. I think I pronounced that right, but probably messed it up a little bit. We did talk about hot spots. This is Yellowstone. And Old Faithful is right past that bus. It says Gray Line. This is the Old Faithful Lodge. Anybody been to the Yellowstone Lodge? Anybody ever been to Yellowstone? Yeah, this is the main lodge. Here's our vans that we took, by the way, on these tours. Most of our participants were from Europe, but we had folks from all over the place. In Yellowstone, it's famous for its wildlife. There are bison, there are grizzly bears. These are elk right down in here. Okay, so that was one of my favorite things about the park. Also, they have lots of hot springs, so that's an indication that something's going on here. I'm going to talk about that here in just a second. Why don't you hit the next slide. That one's a little washed out, but here's some hot springs. And so in this area here of the world, in Yellowstone, and this is in Idaho, Craters of the Moon, we have all these very big ancient, this is a flood basalts. Flood basalts are in the Pacific Northwest. So back to Yellowstone, it is a hot spot. It is a super volcano. It's going to erupt someday. I mean, there's plenty of evidence that it's very active through this hot spot. What is a hot spot? It's just a plume that goes up to the surface. It is stationary while the plates move over it, and it can create very explosive volcanoes, or it can create volcanoes like in Hawaii, which are not nearly as explosive. You know, they have more of this type of lava. So there's two kinds of lava that the Hawaiians have come up with these names. One is pahoehoe, okay, which means ropey. Okay. Hey, Brian, you want to hit the focus on that? Oops. And the other kind, that's all right. The other kind is a'a, or blocky lava. And if you were to walk bare feet on blocky lava, there's many words you could say. But one, I kid you not, it would be ah, ah. And I kid you not that this is named after the utterances that you'd have if you were to walk on this. So, you know, very creative. Okay, next. Another product is obsidian. It's natural glass formed by the extremely rapid cooling of lava. And we don't find this too many places in California. This is up there in northeastern California at, I think it's Lava Beds National Monument. And this was traded throughout California during the Native American era. This was really the gold, the real gold of California, because this could make arrowheads that you could then kill animals with and you know, eat and survive. So we see this traded throughout California from these different sites. Okay, next. So we had the blocky type, and we had the ropey type. Here's some more of the basalts. And this is the Oahe. This is in Idaho. You can see the river, the Oahe River, has cut through these old volcanic flows. That was in the springtime. Okay, next. The Columbia River Gorge are flood basalts. So there are these catastrophic events where lava would go for hundreds of miles and create these layers. And you can kind of see the layers here. This is the Columbia River Gorge. Next. Look at how the rivers have cut through. This is in Rainier National Park. Hey, Brian, can you focus that one? This is such a pretty shot to see more in focus. There you go. A little bit more the other way. There you go. I think that's it. So you can see it's cutting through the lava there. Let's see if this works. Nope. Okay, next. And this Multnomah Falls, this is a famous icon in Oregon. You can see the bridge. It's a footbridge. And it's coming off the basalt flows. Here's some people down here for scale. I think that's in the video, but there it is right down there. Okay, next. And this is Mount St. Helens. It blew up in 1980. And that is no longer looks like that. The top is totally, I bought some slides. Let's take a look at the next one. There were no videos of this. That shows you the times, not one video of this event. Now they stitched together pictures to make time-lapse video, but here's some of the pictures someone took. Look at that, blasting that out. This is going to be called a pyroclastic flow. It's also going to create a lahar where it melts all the snow and takes the trees and creates this hot cement that flows down these rivers and then solidifies later. And there were people killed. There was a person on the mountain. There were people down here by the lake that were suffocated. But fortunately, you know, I think under 20 people died there, so it wasn't 20, 30 people. I want to say 18, but I don't really know my facts. Anyway, next. So it just shot ash up the whole west. Like, let's say if you were, remember the westerlies blow from the west, so if you were downwind, you would get a lot of this ash on your car. Next. After the eruption, here's the crater. Look at that. Took out a lot of the mountain. It was 9,677 feet. Now you can see it goes way down here, 7,200 feet. Okay, next. Now there are three volcanoes in this picture. We're going to go over three types of volcanoes. Okay, one is going to be a composite or stratovolcano. This is Mount Shasta. You can just barely see it here. These are the very violent explosive types. We also have cinder cones. There's a lot of cinder cones and lava beds in northeastern California. I believe this is a cinder cone over in here. And they're small. They blow out just cinders. You could walk up to the top of this mountain. What's really cool, like in Mount Lassen, you get to the top and you think, oh, I'm done. Nope, you keep going down. There's a crater actually way down in here. Okay, and then we have shield volcanoes like in Hawaii, which are these broad volcanoes with layer upon layer of basalts. It's very runny lava, and so it doesn't create your typical cone that you're used to. If we have more of the andesites and the rhyolites and sticky or viscous lava, you're going to get these volcanoes like Mount Shasta that we saw earlier. Okay, next. And this is most likely a cinder cone here. Okay, next. There's Mount Shasta. This is a composite or a stratovolcano. There's actually two volcanoes here, Mount Shasta. You can climb to the top of it. And then Shastina, about 350,000 years ago, somewhere in that time frame, fairly recent in geologic history, this thing blew out and created a huge landslide out there in the Shasta Valley. Okay, next. One of the most famous national parks is Crater Lake. Crater Lake had an ancient mountain that blew up thousands of years ago. When the magma chamber collapsed, it created a big crater in the middle. This would have been empty, no water at the time. And then eventually it filled up with rainwater. There are virtually no boats that are allowed in here, only the national park. Okay? And if you ever get a chance, let me show you the next slide. I think I have some of the clarity of the water. It's just, here's Wizard Island. This is the cinder cone in the middle. Okay, next. There's a boat out there. And this is in the Cascade Mountains. These are all volcanic. You can see another point out here. Okay, next. Kind of more of the same. Let's take a look at the next slide. There you go. Look at that. It has some of the clearest water on the planet. Lake Tahoe used to be like this, but with so many houses, you know, lawns, fertilizers, things like that getting into the lake. Here's the shoreline, and you can actually see down below the waterline. It's just amazingly clear. And when you're up on the cliffs looking straight down, it's even more impressive. It's Mount Lassen. Mount Lassen is kind of a specialized volcano. Some people could put it in the composite or a plug dome. It's very viscous lava. Okay, and Mount Lassen also blew up too, by the way, and we have just some remnants of it around too. But this is a national park as well. Okay, next. This is where I found the andesite. This is the remnants of the old volcano. Here's a person for scale. And broke off mountain. There used to be an old volcano over here. I want to call it Mount Tehama. But it was an ancient volcano that also blew up, and we see the remnants of it. Okay, next. There it is up close. And in Mount Lassen, you see all kinds of mud pots and hot springs. There's even a geyser there. So here's a picture of a kind of a mud pot. And you can see a person here. Okay, next. This is back to Lava Beds National Monument. Let's take a look at the next one. There are small little cones called spatter cones. Here's one. You can see a person. This has had a vent down here. There's kind of like little mini volcanoes around this area here. There's also a lot of lava tubes that you can go in. As the lava flowed, it started to cool around and leave kind of a cave, and then it continued on and left a tube, an area that you can walk in today. Okay, next. I think I might even have a picture inside of there. Nope, not here. And we also have a lot of volcanic remnants. Remember, the edge of the continent used to be a lot further in, let's say in Arizona, and this is, pretty sure this is in Arizona. This is during my, those tour groups I used to lead. It was called Trek America. Here I am, and you can see this is an old volcano. This is the neck of the old volcano. It's pretty flat there, and all of a sudden you're like, what the heck is that? It's an old volcanic neck. And I'm pretty sure that's in Arizona. And, you know, lots of history. I think I want to end here. We're going to talk about folding and faulting later, but that's a good place to stop. Okay, we're done.